Time now 519, and let's help you wake up smarter on this Tuesday morning. Even though we can't see it, there is a lot happening with the air above us. It's a reason why morning fog is thicker on some days than others, and why pollution and haze can stay near the ground. So what exactly is happening? Meteorologist Corrales Ortiz explains what the science says about temperature inversion.
When we get higher in the atmosphere, temperatures normally decrease, with the ground acting as a heat source. When it comes to temperature inversion, though, the opposite is true. We find cooler air closer to the surface and warmer air aloft. But how does this happen? Well, think of inversion as a lid or cap that prevents air near the ground from rising higher into the atmosphere. The layer of warm air is found above the cap, and air near the surface cools much faster. Air rising will cool down enough until it eventually stops rising. Inversion influences everything from visibility, air quality, and even cloud formation. It occurs under specific conditions like clear skies, calm winds, where there's enough moisture or dew present, and are likely to occur near sunset or sunrise. Horizontal smoke patterns and ground fog in low-lying areas are some visible signs of inversion. It usually disperses with the wind and the heating of the day. Inversion can also pose a problem when it comes to pollution. Since the layer acts like a lid, dust particles, smoke, and other pollutants in the air would get trapped underneath. This causes a negative impact on our air quality, which can happen on a small or large area. This is the cause behind big smog events, such as London's Great Smog of 1952. Studies have shown that if chemicals such as weed killers are sprayed on crops during an inversion, that the particles may not make it to the ground and could be carried away and damage unprotected crops over time. We can't avoid inversions, but it's always good to see the link we have with this weather phenomena and how it can affect our quality of life. With THV 11, I'm Corrales Ortiz.
Well, Scott, my question is, how do we even detect that an inversion is happening?
Yeah, it's a good question. Inversions actually are the most relevant both with air quality and during severe weather, and we detect them with weather balloons, which are launched twice a day out at the National Weather Service office in North Little Rock. They launch a big, giant weather balloon. It goes up thousands of feet in the air, and that can give us readings, and we can detect the inversions with the readings from those weather balloons.
Wow, very interesting. Yeah. I didn't know they did that.
Yeah.
Learn something new
Pretty
every
neat.
Day. That's right.